Move the Mouse here, and I'm collaborating with Paradox Interactive to bring you tutorials for the new Parklife expansion. On my channel, I focus on City Skylines and primarily on the Xbox version. In this tutorial, we'll be covering the basics of Parklife and specifically how to use the Park Area tool. The footage that you're seeing is from Xbox, and this is the city of Springdale. I've built up a large downtown area inspired by Manhattan with a space reserved for a central park, but before we take on a massive project like that, let's start off small. The first thing we need to do is break out the Park Area tool. You'll find it here under the new Parklife menu. This works similar to painting districts, but it's independent and can overlap one or many pre-existing districts. As a part of this update, you'll now be able to snap districts and park areas to roads, making quick painting with a controller a breeze. Once you've defined the area, the type of park is determined by the gate you choose to place there. You have two different options for each type of park, either a large or a small main gate. You might want to create a simple, straightforward park, but you can also create amusement parks, zoos, and nature reserves. Once you've placed the main gate for the park of your preference, you can also place smaller side gates to give your citizens other ways to access the park on foot. At this point, you can create footpaths connecting the different gates and areas of the park and start to decorate your new creation. You'll have a few buildings unlocked as soon as you drop in a main gate. As more people visit your park, it will eventually level up, unlocking more ways to customize it and make it your very own. You can see your progress towards reaching those levels by using the Park Area Inspector tool. Here you can see how many visitors your park has seen, check income and expenses related to the park, change policies specific to that park, as well as set ticket prices for accessing it. You can also rename your park here, but make sure you're doing that under the park area info and not simply renaming the main gate building. A quick note, you don't necessarily need a gate to create a generic park. This can be useful for filling in some space between zones, though no gate means no income from tickets, it can help beautify an area. But now you should be ready to get started with Parklife, so go out there and have some fun. Thanks for watching, and be sure to subscribe to the channel and check back for the next Parklife tutorial coming out tomorrow.